Okay, so right away looking at this thing, I can see that the amplitude is going to be 8. Period is always 2 pi divided by that multiple there. So we have b equals 6 pi. So the period is going to be 2 pi over 6 pi. Pi's divide out, 2 goes into 6. That's going to be 1/3. Frequency, remember, is 1 over the period. And if we flip that period, we get 3. And again, what does the frequency mean? That's the number of oscillations per second. So oscillations per second. So if we look at a graph of these and we focus on just 0 to 1, we should see this makes 3 complete waves in 1 second. So let's graph that to compare. So the period, it takes 1/3 of a second to make a wave. That means there's 3 waves per second. So let's graph to see if that looks true. So we are graphing f of x equals 8 times the sine of 6 pi x. Whoa. And then we are going to zoom in. Let's see, I'm just going to change the scale. Let's for y go from maybe negative 10 to 10. And for x, I just want to look at 0 to 1, let's say. So I want to look at the frequency. Whew, that's less messy. All right, so what we should see is from 0 to 1, we should make 1 to here, 2 to here, 3 complete oscillations. So that's the idea of the frequency. So we get 1 period, 1 complete wave is 0.333333 seconds, 1/3 of a second. So that means we get 3 waves per second. So frequency is complete waves per second. Period is how long does it take to make one wave, and they're reciprocals of each other. Nailed it. That was fun. Cute.